Welcome to Pop Quiz. As you can probably tell, the audience is heaving with Valdunican groupies, or rather embarrassing, really. Once again, we have two fine teams chosen for their astounding knowledge of popular music over the last 30 years or so, dating back to the days when Mick Jagger was on his 19th nervous breakdown and couldn't get no satisfaction, to the modern days when the very mention of the words "take that" makes audiences do that. There are no prizes, basically, because we haven't got any. So these pop legends are just competing for the glory of absolutely stuffing, beating the other team by as handsome a margin as they possibly can. So before we get down to the rather serious business of asking them questions like, how is Kid Creole doing now he's going around without his coconuts, let's meet the teams. The first team is captained by a singer-producer who had his first hit in 1969 with the Equals, Eddy Grant. On Eddie's team, still doing the do, Betty Boo. Finally, from the quietly understated Carter, the unstoppable sex machine, please welcome Jim Bob. Now, squaring up against them is a team led by a man who says that the first single he ever bought was by Kenny Ball, which has clearly influenced his image and musical taste ever since. Welcome the very handsome, very hairy Rick Wakeman. On Rick's team, still bathing in the considerable chart success of his recent single, Sweets for My Sweet, say hello to CJ Lewis. And finally, from Go West, please welcome singer-songwriter Richard Drummie. Right, that's about as nice as we get, really. Let's get on with the game. Let's start rather predictably with round one, Name That Year. Now, teams can score 1 point for naming the song of the artist in each clip you're about to see, and 2 points for the year in which they were all hits. OK, Eddie, starting with you. Have a look at this, first of all.
We can dance if we want to. We've got all your life in mind. As long as we abuse it, never gonna lose it. Everything will work out right. I say, we can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Because your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine.
Muttering going on. Right, Eddie.
Wonderful.
Three clips there. What were the clips and the songs, first of all? Who were the artists?
The first one was that Men Without Hats.
What was the song?
It was something dance, wasn't it?
You can dance if you want to.
It was Safety Dance, right? I'll give you that. Go on, next one. Next one?
Paul Young.
Which was called Come Back and Stay.
Well, right. Good work, Jim Bob.
Wonderful.
Third one.
Double Dutch, Malcolm McLaren.
Double Dutch, Malcolm McLaren. Well done, you got the lot now. Two for the year, though. What was the year?
1982.
1983. Yeah! Right, okay, Rick's team. Three tunes, a point each for the name of the song and or the artist, but two more points for telling us the right year when they were hits. Give us the name of the three tunes, first of all, the artists and the songs.
OK, Lieutenant Pigeon, Moldy Old Dough.
Is right.
The second one was the chorus of that unbelievably wonderful record, Mary Had a Little Lamb, but it probably isn't.
It is.
And
it
then
is.
Lastly, Chicory Tip, Son of My Father.
Is right. OK, right. 3 points for that. Now, can you tell me what year it was?
Going for 74 here.
not 74.
We had 75 originally.
What's the matter with you? 72. OK, let's have a look at the scores after the intellectual cut and thrust of the first round. 3-2 Rick Wakeman, 3-2 Eddy Grant's team. So it's going... Well, it's going, really, isn't it? This round features movie themes. Now, each of you individually is going to hear the theme from a well-known feature film. For 2 points, I want you to tell me the artist and the track, OK? CJ, starting with you, have a little listen. Who and what is this? Yeah, very confident, CJ. Come on.
And that's Shaft, and it was by Isaac Hayes.
It's right, well done. You. OK, right. Well, Betty, done. Betty Boo! Your clip, who's singing and what's the tune? I never meant to call you when you found wrong. Okay, it's a movie of the same name. Who is it and what's it called?
It's Prince, obviously. Purple Rain?
Purple Rain is right, well done. Okay. Rick, your turn. What's this and who- The film star Peter O'Toole, Ursula Andress and Peter Sellers, and Woody Allen, actually. But yes. Who sang it and what's it called?
Tom Jones, What's New Pussycat.
Yeah, quite right. OK, Eddy Grant. Yes! Have a listen, Eddy. Have a little blast of this. Oh, my love, my darling. The film was Ghost. What's it called and who sang it?
The Righteous Brothers.
Yeah, and it's called?
How could I get this one wrong?
I think you could.
What about?
I'm going to offer it to Rick Stein for a point. Go on.
Unchained.
Yes,
Lovely.
It is. So a point to Eddy and a point to Rick for picking up on that. Right, over to you, Richard. Now, what do you make of this one? The film was Mad Max 3. I want to know the name of the artist and the name of the song.
That's young T.T., that is. That's T. Turner.
Yep.
We don't need another hero.
He's right for 2 points. Well done.
Aye.
And last, but certainly not least, James Robert, Jim Bob. Have a little listen. Tell me what this is at the end. Right, I can tell you the film was Quadrophenia. It starred Phil Daniels, Leslie Ash, and a little tiny bit of Sting in there as well. But I want to know the name of the artist singing and the name of the song.
It's 5:15 by The Who.
It's right for 2 points. Well done. I can tell you at this point that Eddie's team have got 8 points, but Rick Wakeman now has taken a shock lead with 10 points. Right, it could all change, and it probably will. This round is the one that everybody always dreads on Pop Quiz. It's the lyrics round. It's also an individual round, which means you're entirely on your own to show off, or possibly not. I'm going to read you some well-known pop lyrics. Now, 1 point for correctly identifying the artist, 1 point for the song. Betty, you've got the short story, I'm afraid. You're going to first on this one. So, tell me what these lyrics come from. Word to your moms, I came to drop bombs. I got more rhymes than the Bible got psalms.
That's Big Daddy Kane.
Terribly close. It's House of Pain, Jump Around.
Oh, same sort of thing though, isn't it?
Right, across to you now, CJ. Here we are. Here are your lyrics. Tell me what this song is and who's singing it. Going back to the middle and round again, I'm going to be there to the end.
That's 100% Pure Love, Crystal Waters.
Yes! Oh. Your turn, Eddy, these are your lyrics. What's the song and who sang it? I used to live my life just fast and free and do as I feel, right down to the bone.
Sounds just like me. I don't know.
Turn again?
No guess. I just don't know it.
It's Roachford, isn't it? It's Only to Be With You.
Oh, yeah. I used to live my life this fast and free and do as I
feel. Right down to the bone. Right, as if things aren't going badly enough, Rick, it's your turn now as well. Oh, good, Chris, thanks. Right, here we are, your lyrics. They got a message from the action man. I'm happy. Hope you're happy too. It's an individual round.
But you're right.
It's Bowie, but I can't remember the I got a nasty feeling I played on it. Oh, Changes. It's not Changes, but no.
I'll give you a point for David Bowie. It's actually Ashes to Ashes.
Lively with the pen.
Jim Bob, your lyrics. On holiday, love in the 90s is paranoid. On sunny beaches, take your chances.
Blur, Girls and Boys.
It's right for 2 points. Well done. That was really good. Now, finally, Richard, here come your lyrics. I want to know the name of the tune and the name of the artist. I'm on your side when times get rough, and friends just can't be found.
Like a Bridge Over Troubled Water?
By
Simon and Garfunkel.
Yes, correct. Well done. At the end of this, it's all changed. Eddy Grant now on 10 points, but Rick Wakeman with 15. OK, teams, this round is particularly unpleasant, as if the last one wasn't nasty enough. We're going to play you two videos simultaneously, at the same time, and at the same time, ask you to listen to a piece of unrelated music, OK? There's 2 points for each artist and song you correctly recognise from the two videos that you see together, and 1 point for the artist and the song that you hear. OK? Clear as mud. Right, Rick. He was swelled by his mouth of money. Then, Rick, whatever was in the middle of all that. What was the song, first of all, that was playing, the unrelated song to anything else?
Wishing I Was Lucky, Wet, Wet, Wet.
Correct, for a point. Right, now, what was in all that video?
Well, thanks to Richard, we're pretty certain it was Video Killed the Radio Star, Buggles was one.
Is right, 2 points.
Now we're in real trouble. But we thought it could be...
No. Were you going to say Sting?
Yes.
That was a bum steer.
It was a bum steer, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
Well, we'd like to say that it wasn't Sting, the other one.
Yes.
You can't have a point with not being Sting, can you? Betty's getting all excited. Betty, you can take a point for that if you want.
New Order.
And the song was called?
It wasn't Blue Monday, was it?
No. You're right, it wasn't Blue Monday.
True Faith.
True Faith is right, I'll give you a point for that. Okay, right. Meanwhile... I can give you 3 points in all, because you got Buggles Video Killed the Radio Star, you got Wet, Wet, Wet was right, you get a point for that, and I gave a point to Betty as well. I can tell you that New Order won the Best Video for True Faith at the 1988 BPI Awards. The same year that Wet, Wet, Wet won the Best Newcomer Award. Let's have a look at the whole thing now, completely unscrambled. Young, it didn't stop you coming through. Oh, oh, oh. Right, Eddie's team, your turn. Two videos playing simultaneously, and at the same time, you'll be listening to a piece of unrelated music, OK? Here it all comes. Baby, I love my body, senor. Oh, you know that I will. Oh, summer nights, little and stars above. Oh, I love you still. A serenade, I love to sing you. The latest rose I always bring you. Save your love for romance. I've heard that song for years, and now I remember why. So, Eddie, first and foremost, tell me the extra song in there. And the artist and the song?
Save Your Love For Me, Renny and Renato.
He's right for a point. OK, right, now, what was in the video? There were two tunes and two artists in amongst all that.
Rio, Duran Duran.
He's right, well done, Betty.
And...
Boomtown Rats.
Boomtown Rats, Stand Like Monday.
He's right, you got the lot. Well done, 5 points. Oh, that'll be unbearable. Just in case you think we're making all this up, it was all in there all the time. Have another look.
parachute. Ooh, the whole day down.
Right, let's look at the scores at the end of that round. 17 now to Eddie Grant, getting closer. 18 to Rick Wakeman. Whoa. Right, this round is cover versions. Each team will be subjected to three versions of the same well-known song, but each one by a different artist. For 1 point, name the song. There's also 1 point for each artist correctly identified. Eddie, we'll start with you. Your team first. Have a listen to all these.
Each night before you go to bed, my baby, whisper a little.
Revolve in my baby, and tell the good Lord above, this is dedicated to the one I love. Oh,
right, come on, give me the song first of all.
Dedicated to the one I love.
Yeah, okay, well, there you got a point now.
One was Biddy McLean.
One was Biddy McLean.
The other was.
Is it a help? Is it the Mamas and Papas?
It is the Mamas and Papas. Yeah. That was the.
That's the original.
Biggest hit, yeah? That was one of them. One more, you only one short. Go on.
The last one was. Gilman's.
Give it
They were girls, yeah. I can give you 1 point for what you got. I can offer one to Rick Wakeman. Who was that doing the other version of the song?
Shangri-La.
It wasn't the Shangri-La's, it was the other one. It was the Shirelles.
That's what I meant.
Started with an S, Chris. I mean,
right, okay, Rick, you're lot. Three versions of the same song. What's the song and who are the three separate artists singing it?
Well, I can't forget tomorrow when I think of all my sorrow. I had you there. Then I'll let you go.
And now it's only fair that I should let you know what you should know.
I can't live if living is without you. I can't live.
What's the tune, first of all? The
tune's Without You.
Okay, so you've got a point for that. Now give me three versions.
The first one sounded like an appalling demo.
So you don't know the first second one, well, basically, right?
We're guessing, really. The second one, Olivia Newton-John?
It was the Nolans. Pretty similar, really, in their way.
This is pop quiz, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay, we're doing awfully well there, aren't we? Harry Nilsson's the last.
Badfinger, who wrote it, was the first one, and the Nolans. And so you got 1 point for getting Harry Nilsson, and you got 1 point for the song. Let's have a look at the scores at the end of that. Well, it's a bit of a cliffhanger now. 20 points to Rick Wakeman, 20 points to Eddie Grant. Right, here we go, round six. You're on your own again, all of you, with a chance. Oh, good. With a chance to air your vast and specialised knowledge individually. 2 points for each correct answer. CJ, we'll start with you. Now, I'm going to show you a clip. It features Mr. and Mrs. Ranks' little boy, Shabba. Shabba Ranks there on a song with the politically incorrect title Trailer Loader Girls. Now, your question is... CJ, for 2 points, can you name Shabba's singing partners on his hits She's a Woman and House Call? 1 point for each one you get correct.
OK, on House Call, that was Maxie Priest.
Is right.
And She's a Woman was Skritti Politti.
Green Gartside from Skritti Politti. OK, well done. Here we are, buddy. Have a look at this. Another piece of vintage archive footage. Here it comes.
I've been driving in my car,
nice silly videos. Madness, of course, and I like driving in my car. Now, for 2 points, Betty, can you tell me this? Madness had 15 top 10 hits, but only so far one number one. What was it?
House of Fun.
He's right for 2 points. Well done. OK, Wakeman, a clip featuring the shy and retiring Tubes coming up. That was the Tubes and White Punks on Dope. Fee Waybill there, the lead singer, looking more like Julian Clary on Dope. Right, Rick, this is your question. Can you tell me either of the Tubes' other British hits? A point for each.
Oh, Christ. The British hits.
Yes, please.
Wouldn't like some American ones.
No.
I honestly can't actually remember, which is a shame, actually, because I actually discovered the band in San Francisco. They used to play naked.
Well, they virtually still do, don't they? From what we see. Eddie, any idea?
Want to wait anymore?
Oh, I've already given it to Eddie. I can tell you, don't want to wait anymore. Would have got your point, Rick Wakeman, if you'd said it about 20 minutes ago.
Love something.
Or Prime Time was the other one. OK, right, Eddie, it's your turn. Your clip needs no introduction at all.
Have a mind,
wasn't Keith pretty?
Did he Rolling look like that?
Yeah, apparently. The Rolling Stones appearing on Top of the Pops there in 1967. Hardly changed at all, have they? Now, Eddie, here's your question. What was the Stones' first ever top 10 hit?
Come On.
It wasn't. Ow. It was not Fade Away. Richard, here's your clip. Questions coming up at the end. Have a look first.
All the trees, put them in a tree near the and they charge all the people a dollar and a half just to see them. Woman always seen as though don't know what you got till it's gone. They pay paradise and they put up a parking lot.
Joni Mitchell there, song Big Yellow Taxi. Richard, Joni made an album in 1979 by way of a tribute to a great jazz master, but who was it?
The album was called Mingus, a tribute to Charlie Mingus.
It's right, for 2 points, well done. Right, finally this man, Jim Bob. Here comes The Jam, making their very first appearance on Top of the Pops in 1977. The Jam in the City. Here's the question. For 2 points, can you name the three members of The Jam?
Paul Weller, Bruce Foxton, Rick Butler.
He's right, you are a Jam fan. 2 points. So let's have a look at the scores at the end of that as we go into the final round. 24 to Eddie Grant, 24 to Rick Wakeman's team. Right. It's all down to the wire, guys. Here we go. It's the quick-fire round. Fingers on your buzzers. 2 points for each correct answer. Who is insane in the brain? CJ.
Cypress Hill.
Cypress Hill is right. Well done. Who's Declan McManus, better known as? Jim Bob.
Elvis Costello.
Is right. What does SWV stand for? Betty.
Sisters with Voices.
Is right. What does ELO stand for? Jim Bob.
Electric Light Orchestra.
You're on a flyer. Who is ELO's lead singer? Richard.
Jeff Lynne.
Is right. Two more points. Who's the Cornflake Girl? Jim Bob.
Tori Amos.
Well done. The Division Bell is whose latest album?
Pink
Jim
Floyd.
Bob.
It's not work.
Pink Floyd.
Well, I'm Pink Floyd. Who is the Pretenders' lead singer? Richard.
Is he Hine?
It's right, two more points. Take That, Relight My Fire featured which?
Lulu.
Do that. Lulu is right, well done. Who is the Kinks' lead singer? Richard.
Ray Davis.
Ray Davis is right. Let's have a look at the scores as we go to the end. 32 now. Disappointing total from Rick Wakeman, while Eddie Grant's team have coasted to victory with 36. That's about it from us. Thanks to our team. Thanks to Jim Bob, to Eddie, to Betty, the winners. And thanks to CJ Lewis, to Rick Wakeman and Richard, the losers. Good night from all of us. We leave you with the Kinks, and I just hope you got rid of them by this time next week. Bye-bye.
The taxman's taken all my dough and left me in my stately home, blazing on a sunny afternoon, and I can't sail my yacht. He's taken everything I got. All I've got's this sunny afternoon. Save me, save me, save me from this squeeze. I got a big fat mama trying to break me. And I love to live so pleasantly. Live